is plenty good on mid laners. Porpoise is going to find Gamsu, though. And the fight begins. A flash knockback from Gragas. Can he pull back Gamsu? Yes, he can. No flash left for Maokai means that will be a kill. It goes to Porpoise. First blood teammate.
Yeah.
And thanks to Dig being shoved in, or sorry, shoving in against teammate, no real contest for Dragon. No one's showing up. And Zingy on Fiddlesticks will get his team Dragon number one right there. First blood teammate, first Dragon Dignitas.
And once again, they buy more time for Kiwi Kid to roam here. Core JJ down bottom, playing fairly defensive. Ooh, here it comes.
All right, Azingi's going to Crow Storm. He's going to find Solution. The Fear still goes through, but wow, they trade it back. Porpoise soloed Annie, but the mid lane kill comes back all the same. In comes Cali Trolls. Explosive Cask is up. Gets Azingi right back into the team. Porpoise to claim another with the team, and Dodo roamed up, and the Soul Shackles, and the Body Slam. 4-1 teammate.
Late game scaling. Adding Lich Bane, and you sort of add this artificial scaling with another AP ratio. Don't think they'll need it for this kill.
I think they're going to be okay. Dark Binding just for fun. There's the quick kill. The ward coverage not enough for Dignitas, but now will they stay? Kiwi Kid is here. Explosive Cap does not knock back Azingi. There comes Tibbers. There comes Fear. Down goes Calitrols. The re-engage by Dignitas does work.
Especially with the good Zed being picked up.
Absolutely.
All right. Wards on Dragon do not matter. Azingi going to burn it down. And Porpoise does not buddy up here. So top lane Maokai seems to be in a bit of trouble.
Oh, Gamsu getting just focused on. He's already 0-2. It's about to be 0-3. He does not have flash. Vengeful Maelstrom will deal some damage, but a nice barrel from Calitrols means to get the kill. The 1v1 Slushy versus Shifter easily goes Shifter's way. Thanks to some help from Kiwi Kid, so solo kills on both sides of the map. Mean enough. Kiwi just leading the team on a wild goose chase now. The rest of Dig are trying to push down mid. Sivir is there to defend.
How long will he survive?
2-1. Gone. Did they rampage for Porpoise?
Ran through and killed one pink ward.
For JJ, knocked into the wall. His flash is down. Binding hits. Deathmark means he's gonna go down. Slushy. 2-2-0.
That was opponents. Heartbreaking for Azingi that he hasn't been able to combine it yet. They might give up the dragon just based off on that vision control and the lack of Fiddlestick Zonyas. Once again, let's take a look at the spell shield. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
The ward that was leading up to that bush. So he knew Azingi was on that side of the map, and it was a good guess.
Well, this is a pretty good attempt to Shifter force the Zonyas away. Now, Core JJ, the target, takes so much AoE, and they trade back onto Shifter as well. A 2-0, and Team 8 look poised to take so much now.
Very rough for Team 8 to come back, but a kill on the Calitrols to get them on the right path.
He's on the wrong side of this map, pops the W to heal himself maybe a little bit here. Nice snipe.
Kiwi
they want to give Azingi the kill. Oh no! Oh, that was closer than it needed to be. And it's unfortunate that Dig have not been able to find aggressive moves of their own. They've always been the one getting jumped on, dictated to. You can see they pop Gamsu, they run away. Azingi's forced to Crow Storm, basically nothing. And then, okay, great, we can re-engage. Fear Porpoise, put the silence on, actually buys a lot of time, and he does re-engage. In comes Dignitas, but the counter-engage. Over and over, back and forth, Porpoise looks for a little bit more. They've dropped down Annie, they've dropped down Gamsu. Azingi's gonna be the third casualty as well. Core JJ forced to run. That whole fight was without the mid laners, but the 4v4 easily went teammates' way, and they own mid lane. First concerted Baron attempt for teammate. However, their tanks are low. Calitrols needs to absorb these attacks to keep Porpoise alive. Ezreal comes by, shouldn't
can
kill
he get a
Porpoise.
Kill? Porpoise is low.
Goes up to the side. Good moves there. 2,000 health. And, oh, healed for a second. There's the smite. There's the kill.
And he has a distortion boots that he's actually had for quite a while here.
Yeah.
Saw it about 10 minutes ago. Large, large portion of his damage from getting in for his Lich Bane empowered, W empowered auto attack. And we're about to see it. Never mind.
He needed a taunt more.
Just popped the barrel.
Take a page from Slushy's book, but clean and secure. Nate takes him down. And now with a 10-kill lead, teammate 13,000 up. Look for the bottom inhibitor, their first of the game. Slowly but surely, Maple Street is looking to knock that one down. Minions helping as well, and Dignitas have just not found their way in. Without Kiwi Kid, the dedicated engage isn't there. Thanks to Calitrols, he is dead. Down goes the inhibitor well before Kiwi Kid respawns.
Split mid and top. They've got deep wards inside the wall to see Azingi. Good pink there, but they've already been shoved off the turret.
Oh, the flash engage onto Azingi, forcing him to flash out. Pop the Zonius to dodge explosive cast. But by the way, Azingi, you are still dead. Porpoise gets his 7th kill of the game. The team fight starts, and Sivir does drop. But will it be enough for Dignitas? They're trying to get some kills in, but two more casualties fall through. A double kill for Porpoise. Gamsu's gonna fall as well. Only Shifter is alive. And only one death for teammate means another inhibitor goes down. And now with minions in the base, this could be the game-winning push. Nice flex shield stops the charm. And here we go. Auto attacks come on in. Shifter could not possibly clear this entire team by himself. The barrels from Kelly, the shuriken stylish from Slushi. But it's going to be enough. Teammate are going to end the week 2-0. Their first of the season, I believe. Putting them back into that gigantic tie for fifth place as they hold on to their dreams of a playoff spot.
Maple Street next to air out his feet when he plays Hit of Legends.
Absolutely.
It's more comfortable this way.